You guys like to learn a trick?
Yeah! Yeah.
Good. At one time or another, you've probably seen a magician take a piece of rope and cut it and put it back together again. That's what we're going to do. I'm going to do the trick for you, and I'll show you step by step how it was accomplished. Before we start, I'd like to have someone from the audience thoroughly examine this piece of rope, make sure it is, in fact, what it appears to be, an ordinary, unprepared piece of rope. Would you go over every inch of that? Okay, thank you so much. I can make sure there are no trap doors or mirrors, no hidden assistance, doesn't stretch or anything like that. Excellent. Okay, good. Good. Thank you very much. You have to give him a big hand. Yeah. You sure you didn't miss anything, right? It's just an ordinary piece of rope, obviously. Otherwise, I wouldn't have let you look at it. It's just a piece of rope like you find in any bedroom. The secret. The secret to this trick is not in the rope. It's in a special knot that magicians have kept secret for hundreds of years. It's called the Mongolian Pop Knot. It was invented by the famed horsemen of Mongolia. It's a kind of a slip knot. Sometimes those boys had to leave town in kind of a hurry. Now, first step is you want to measure the rope carefully. You want to make sure that when you cut, you get two pieces of rope exactly the same length. To put these back together again, you tie a Mongolian pop knot. Here's how it's tied. You take one rope, twist it around the other rope like this, come back over this way, come around, come through, and pull tight. You go back and forth the same way as you went in and out, and then you go in and out at the same time as you went back and forth. You twist. You know, some of you are laughing, but there's people here trying to learn. You twist, come around, and pull tight. You have one Mongolian pop knot. Now, at this point, you simply reach in your pocket. You take some magic pixie dust. I just call it pixie dust. I don't know what they call it in Mongolia. You sprinkle it on the knots like this. In a few seconds, that pixie dust will cause the knot to dissolve. Seeing exactly how to tie that knot. So I'll do it again. This time we'll cut the rope into three even pieces. That'll give you twice as much chance to see how the knot is tied. Because it takes two Mongolian pop knots in order to put three pieces of rope back together again. Am I going too fast? That rarely happens, really. Cut one here. We cut ones down here. Now, remember when you try this at home, make sure you cut all three ropes exactly the same length. If you make a mistake there, the trick won't work. No, I'm not kidding. You want to cut all three ropes exactly the same length. If you make a mistake here, I'm not kidding. If you were to get one rope a little short, I'm not going to get anywhere with that. And you might have one right and the other one too long. It's all got to be the same length. The same length. Now, well, this could happen to anyone. So if it happens to you, there is a way out as long as I am teaching you the trick. I'll teach you what we magicians call a contingency plan. You make a mistake cutting the ropes, you fold them over one at a time, like the short, medium, and long. You say the magic word, sim, salabim. Well, you have to say these with a certain amount of conviction.
To the fairy dust.
Pixie dust. That's just what I call it. That's from Mongolia. This is This is something else. You have to stretch the ropes. You have to say Sims Alabim. Shut up. This is the hard part of the trick. Sim Salabim. I know it's stupid, but I know, see, it's stupid sounding, but it works. Back to the Mongolian pop knot. We take rope number one, rope number two. I'm going to tie these together. Watch closely. I'll go slow. You take one rope, twist it around the other rope like this, come back over this way, come around, come through, and pull tight. You go back and forth the same way as you went in and out, and then you go in and out at the same time. As you know, I fail to see the humor. And I don't think I'm alone in that. You twist, come around, and pull tight. You have one Mongolian pop knot. The second knot is tied the same way. You may want to take notes. You take one rope, twist around the other rope like this, come back over this way, come around, come through, and pull tight. Yeah. You go back and forth the same way as you went in and out, and then you go in and out at the same time as you went back and forth. You twist, come around, and pull tight. You have two Mongolian pop knots. We might have a pop quiz. You guys aren't really paying that much attention. At this point, you simply reach in your pocket, you take some magic.
Pixie dust.
That's very good. That's very studious. You sprinkle the pixie dust on the knots like this. Any questions so far?
No.
What?
No.
Where do you get the pixies?
Well, you see, some of you drowning these questions out. It's important. People have to learn. Well, pixies are always after a rain, you know, on a full moon. Did you not have magic 101? How did you get it? I grind my own. I sent the kids out of the house. Because pixies can make a hell of a noise. A blender. It can be distressing for the very young. Any other stupid questions? In a few seconds, the pixie dust will cause the...